Back in May, NBC shattered one of the media's remaining glass ceilings by hiring the first female president of a network television news division. Her name is Deborah Ternus, and she started her career across the pond working with Britain's ITN. Let me tell you what the conventional wisdom was in the TV industry back when she was hired. People said her first, second, third, fourth priorities would be fixing the Today Show, which is stuck in second place in the mornings. And it does need fixing, but other shows at other times of day need fixing too. Just 2 weeks ago, in the evening, ABC's Diane Sawyer beat NBC's Brian Williams for the first time in nearly 5 years. Maybe that's just a fluke, but it's probably not. The news magazine Rock Center was recently canceled. And NBC's Sunday morning show, Meet the Press, has lost a lot of ground to its competitors as well. NBC used to be the dominant brand in network news. Now, well, that's debatable. Returning to the roundtable to talk about NBC's challenges and more, Paul Farhi, the media reporter for The Washington Post, and Jane Hall, a journalism professor at American University. Jane, I want to put up the graphic from TV Newser this week, Deborah Ternus's first week on the job, and it showed how challenging this job is going to be. It says, Good Morning America has extended its winning streak among total viewers to 50 weeks, its longest run at number one in more than 21 years. And once you fall to second place, it's really hard to get back up, right?
Well, these changes in morning television are glacial, and once they turn, they sometimes stay turned for a long time. That's got to be your first job. Multi-million dollars, as you've written, are on the line between being first and being second. These are a huge profit center. They are largely female audiences, and they misjudged, as you wrote so well, how the largely female audience would react to Ann Curry seeming to be pushed aside. They did the same thing 20 years earlier with Jane Pauley seeming to be pushed aside. And this is a really big issue that she's going to have to deal with right away.
Right, right. Paul, it's worth pointing out these network news shows still command a big audience versus cable news, and that's why we care about them, right?
That's right. I mean, it's the tallest building in Wichita phenomenon these days. Everybody's losing audience. The audience is going to 100 different channels, 1,000 different channels, maybe 5,000 different channels with the internet. And yet the networks still, because of their historical advantage, still command the biggest share. And,
right.
You know, that's a very valuable position, even in this world that's flying apart in many, many different ways.
Flying apart. I like that.
Yeah.
Jane, what's the significance of having a woman in charge of a network news division for the first time?
Well, I think it's important. I think it's another shift in moving women into the executive suites that's going on around the country. I think the symbolism probably of anchors was more important because that's what the viewers know. When
right.
Diane Sawyer and Katie Couric came into these jobs, it used to be a woman wouldn't be seen, I was told, as the voice of authority in a time of crisis. I think it's less important. I don't think we should assume she'll be any more sensitive to the women viewers than to the men, but it's a good symbol. Mm.
We should also point out that she, I believe, is the first British national to run an American network news division. And we don't know how that plays out either.
That could be very interesting, though.
You know, one other thing I wanted to mention, the nightly newscasts, among everybody else, have maintained their audience. There is still an audience for a summary of the day's news on all three of those broadcasts. They're the one place that's amazingly stable.
Is nightly news.
Yeah.
Another topic affecting NBC News this week is the Hillary miniseries over at NBC Entertainment. We've seen the RNC come out and say they're not going to be having any debates with NBC if this miniseries goes forward. They say the same thing about CNN because CNN's working on a documentary about Hillary Clinton. And earlier today on State of the Union, Ryan Priebus, the chairman of the RNC, was asked about it. So let's roll that tape and see what he said.
Totally ridiculous and stupid. The fact is, what channel am I going to tune into to see the documentary and the miniseries that is all about promoting Hillary Clinton? And at this point, it sounds like it's going to be CNN and NBC. And if that's the case, they're not going to be involved in our debates, period.
Paul, let me play a devil's advocate here. Isn't this all a smokescreen designed to distract from the fact that the Republicans want to have fewer debates overall? They want to have their candidates less exposed in 2016, and that's why they're making a big fuss of this?
Well, I won't touch that part, but I do think that they want equal time, and that's what Ryan Priebus is going for here. You know, I don't remember the RNC being all that upset when CBS did a miniseries about the Reagans. They did have a few problems once the facts started leaking out about that miniseries. But nevertheless, you know, this is the entertainment division of NBC, not the news division. And we don't know what the content is. Mm-hmm. There's plenty of warts to bring up about Hillary Clinton. It's not going to be all glory for her.
Well, you know, Chuck Todd and Andrea Mitchell have already talked about how this is, as Todd said, a nightmare for them. Viewers, I don't think, are going to make a difference. The thing that's funny to me is who's to say, if this talks about Monica Lewinsky, which it will, who's to say this is going to be great for Hillary Clinton to bring all of that bad news up again? I think Priebus, I'll go out on a limb. I saw Priebus's interview with Sean Hannity about this. He basically said, we want debates we can control. These guys are not going to promote us. So I think it's a ploy, and I'm sure it's a sincere ploy, but I think it is a ploy about the debates to say we're going to take our ball and bat and go home.
Except, on the other hand, from the RNC's perspective, you're going to have 4+ hours, or I'm not sure how long it's going to be, of primetime coverage, a primetime story about Hillary Clinton. Mm-hmm. You know, they'd probably like that for Marco Rubio and Jeb Bush, et cetera.
One more NBC story this week. Alec Baldwin in talks for a show on MSNBC. This is not a joke. I think it may be announced as early as this week. Will you all be watching an Alec Baldwin talk show?
I'd watch that. I think he's an interesting personality. Look, the cable networks do not have hosts who are from a news background necessarily. Why not Alec Baldwin? He's a guy who mixes it up. It could be exciting and energetic.
I think it could be good. You know, I've interviewed him. He's very interested in politics. How he would be on a regular show, and, you know, you have to book people, you have to be a host. How the rest of the lineup feels about this, I'd be curious to know how some of the other hosts feel about him. He certainly would get a lot of tune in the beginning.
I think so. He's got a great podcast, so if it's anything like the podcast he does online, it could be great. Well, Jane Hall, Paul Fahey, thanks for joining us.